AWS Secrets Manager lets you securely retrieve secrets for use in your Amazon EKS Kubernetes pods. In this video, we will create a secret in AWS Secrets Manager and then create a simple Nginx deployment to demonstrate how the secrets can be used. We will mount the secret as a file as well as we will expose it to the pod via environment variable. To achieve that, we will deploy Kubernetes Secrets Store CSI driver and AWS component, AWS Secrets Manager and Config Provider. Working together, they will let you retrieve the secret and provide it to the pod. To configure access, we will create an OpenID Connect provider and associate the IAM role with the Kubernetes service account. Let's get started. You can find the source code and the commands in my GitHub repository in the README file. I'll attach the link to the video. As always, let's create an admin user with programmatic access only. Mainly, we will use it to create and access AWS EKS cluster. After you download the credentials, let's go to the terminal and set up the AWS default profile, or you can expose environment variables if you wish. The next step is to create a secret in AWS Secrets Manager. You may store database credentials or just a single API token. Actually, this process will work with both the AWS Secrets Manager and Parameter Store. Alright, let's select the other type of secrets and create a key value. Let's give my API token name for the key and just random stuff for the value. On this page, you need to provide a secret name. You will use it to reference it in the Kubernetes later on. Let's call it a prod service token. In this example, we won't use resource permissions. We will grant access directly to the IAM role. If you wish to learn how to use it, I have another video, AWS Lambda Secrets Manager example, two ways to grant access. Also, skip the rotation section. Here you can find code samples, which is useful when you want to use API calls to get the secret. In our case, the secret store CSI driver provider will handle it. Now let's open the secret and inspect the Amazon resource name. AWS will append a random suffix to your secret IRN. Later, when you grant access to the IAM role, we will need to provide this. Now create EKS cluster using ekctl. You can configure your cluster by overriding some default values with the CLI flags, or you can create a YAML config. Let's call our EKS my cluster, place it in the cheapest US East 1 region and specify the version. You need to provide at least two availability zones. Finally, define the managed instance group. Managed instance group is created by EKS itself. Go to a terminal and use ekctl to create a cluster. When you use ekctl to create a cluster, it will leverage the CloudFormation engine and create at least two stacks, one for cluster and one for instance group. The instance group is created as afterscaling group and you can find it in the EC2 section. Here you have one minimum capacity, which is mapped to min size, and maximum capacity, which is mapped to max size. If you want to afterscale your EKS cluster, you need a third-party tool that can adjust desired capacity based on the load. I have a lesson if you're interested, EKS cluster afterscaling. Let's verify that the kubectl client is able to communicate with Kubernetes API server. If we get a response, means everything is good and we can continue. I don't spend a lot of time on this section since I assume that you already have a cluster and just want to integrate Secrets Manager with Kubernetes. The next step is to create IAM OpenID Connect provider for EKS. By the way, if you're not using EKS and deploy Kubernetes yourself to AWS, you still can follow along. At this point, you just need to create an IAM role and attach it to the Kubernetes instance group instead of creating OpenID Connect provider. To start, you need to go to EKS page and copy the OpenID Connect provider URL. Now go to IAM service and under identity providers add a new one. As you can expect, it will be OpenID Connect type. Then paste the URL and click Get Thumbprint. Under the audience, enter sts.amazon.aws.com. We will update this in the trust section later. Next, we need to create IAM policy to read secrets. You can use JSON objects to configure access. It will be a single statement with effect allow, then we need to specify the action, get secret value and identify the resource. Let's go back to the AWS Secrets Manager and copy the IRN of our token. Give it a unique name, for example API token read access, and click create policy. Now let's create an identity IAM role for Kubernetes service account. Select web identity type and find the OpenID Connect provider that we created earlier. Filter policies by customer managed and select API token read access. Call it API token access. Try to use the same names when you follow along, since sometimes we have references in different places. When you get this working, then you can come up with your own names. Now click on the role and go to Trust Relationships. Here we want to update trust that only one single Kubernetes service account can use it and nobody else. I'll attach the link to the official documentation. Here, instead of the audience, put sub and update the value. It's going to be a service account located in the production namespace, and the name of the service account is the last argument, Nginx. Now we need to associate IAM role with Kubernetes service account. Let's create a folder Nginx where we're going to put all Kubernetes related files. First of all, let's create a new production namespace for our demo. This has to match with the namespace that you specified in the IAM role. Then create a Kubernetes service account. Put it in the production namespace as well, and most importantly, add an annotation to allow the service account to assume the role. Let's copy the IRN of the role from the AWS console. Now go back to the terminal and apply the whole folder to create a namespace and service account. Let's list namespaces now. We have a production namespace created 9 seconds ago. Also, let's check the service accounts. We have a default service account created every time when you create a namespace and Nginx service account. This service account now has access to the secret. The next step is to install the Kubernetes Secret Store CSI driver. It integrates secret stores with Kubernetes via container storage interface, Volume. I'll show you both installation ways, using plain YAML and at the end with the Helm chart. I think the best way to follow along is to clone my GitHub repository or at least open it in the browser. First of all, we need to create two custom resource definitions. Secret provider class. And let's create the second one right away. It is secret provider class pod status. Let's apply them from the terminal. Let's see if those crowds were created. Alright, they're here. Let's complete our deployment. It will include a service account. Then the cluster role. Here is an important section. Suppose you want to use your secrets as environment variables. You need to grant access for secrets. The way it will work, the store driver will retrieve a secret from the AWS Secrets Manager and create a Kubernetes secret. Then you will use the secret value in your deployment to create environment variable. Next is cluster role binding to associate the service account with the RBAC role that we just created. We need to run the secrets store CSI driver on each node, so let's create a daemon set to do that. Finally, create a CSI driver. go over to the terminal and apply. Check the logs to see if there are any errors in the output. You can use the -L flag to select ports by the labels. You don't need to run the following two commands. If you're a Helm user, you can add a repo and use Helm install. It will give you exactly the same thing, but without Kubernetes secrets access by default. So if you will use Helm, you need to add RBAC permissions if you want to use secrets as environment variables. Out of the box, if you deploy using Helm and default values, you will only be able to mount secrets as files inside the pod. Something to keep in mind. Next, install AWS secrets and configuration provider. The AWS provider for the secret store CSI driver allows you to make secrets stored in secrets manager and parameters stored in the parameter store appear as files mounted in the Kubernetes pods or use them as environment variables. I don't have a Helm for you to deploy this component, so let's create a folder and place YAML out there. The first is a service account. We need them for RBAC role-based control, since all of these components require some sort of access for the Kubernetes API server. Then again the cluster role. Cluster role binding. And a daemon set as well. Let's apply them now. We have a CSI secrets store provider running. Check the logs. Now let's create a secret provider class. This object will map the secret in the secrets manager with a Kubernetes provider. First of all, it's a secret provider class. It must be placed in the same namespace where you deploy your service, in our case Nginx. Then under the parameters section, we need to specify the name of the secret. We have a couple of options. We can use either secrets manager or SSM parameter. Then we can optionally create an alias. This will be the name of the file that you will mount to the pod. Since we also want to create an environment variable, we need to create a Kubernetes secret. API token will be a Kubernetes secret name. Secret token is just a key within the secret. Let's go and apply it. It's time for the demo. Let's split the screen. I want to show you the logs from the CSI driver. You can immediately see if you get an error or if the secret was successfully mounted. Let's create the last Kubernetes object for this video, deployment with Nginx. Alright, first of all, it's just a simple deployment based on the open source Nginx reverse proxy. We don't even need it at all, we just need a placeholder image. First, to mount the secret as a file, we need to create a volume using the CSI keyword and point it to the provider class. Then let's use this volume and mount it to the mount API token. Second, let's expose this secret as environment variable. Let's call it API token and get value from the Kubernetes secret API token. It was created automatically by the controller. Here's where important to use our Nginx service account that has proper access. Let's deploy it. In the bottom window, you can see that the secret was retrieved successfully. If we misconfigured RBAC or IAM policy or role, you will get an error with permission denied. Now let's go inside the pod and print the file content first. -IT stands for interactive shell, then the pod ID and a command to execute. Let's use cat to print the content. You can see the secret value, it's a key value from the AWS secrets manager, my API token and the random value that we entered. Now let's see if we have environment variable. Alright, ENV is accessible as well with our secret. Now, as a bonus, if you're a frequent Kubernetes user, you need to install KubeContext right now. It's a CLI tool that simplifies switching between namespaces and Kubernetes contexts if you have multiple clusters. For example, you want to get pods in the production namespace. You always need to use the -n flag and provide a namespace, in this case production. All the operations in that namespace will require you to use this flag, which is very annoying sometimes. If you install KubeContext, you can use the kubens command and switch to the production namespace. Then just run kubectl get pods, you'll get the same result, but without -n flag. If you run KubeContext, you can switch between clusters quickly as well. To list namespaces, just run kubens. The production namespace is active. Please do me a favor and like this video, it really helps. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.